day number 19 of our Christmas Advent yoga sessions. So today is all about the hips. We are going to be opening them out, giving them a good stretch to release any tension. You may find a block beneficial, so pause this video and go and grab one if you think you'll need it. Otherwise, come and sit in the center of your mat with your feet together in our butterfly pose, ready to begin. Okay, so arriving in your butterfly pose, keeping the feet a little bit further away from the body if you want to. You can bring them in, but instead of pulling the feet towards you, you can place the hands behind you, lift the glutes up and place them back down. So finding which position feels comfortable for you, let the hands rest on the knees, just over. Not holding any tension anywhere in the body, and just begin to take deep breaths in and exhale slowly, either through the nose or out the mouth. Keeping the spine nice and long. Chin parallel to the floor. And if you wish to grab hold of a block, you can place that in front of you. You don't need to have a block, you can just walk the hands too. But begin just to lengthen through the spine. I'll spin around to show you. So that the hands rest on the block. You're not rounding and looking down and clenching any tension anywhere in the jaw or through the neck and shoulders. So keep the space there as you rest the hands either on a block or keeping the fingertips to the earth, hinging forwards, leading with the chest as you're coming into your butterfly pose. Slowly release and just move the knees up and down. Then start to draw the legs in, stretch out the legs, sitting onto your sitting bones, hands resting either side. In Dandasana, we lift the arms up. Exhale, just reaching towards those toes. Again, you don't need to be having your chest down to the thighs. You can hold the shins. You can grab a strap. Whatever feels comfortable and easier for you. So try and keep the arms long. Don't hold the very ends of the strap. Keeping your breath smooth, equal. Hinge forwards a little bit more if you can. And then slowly release. Send the arms all the way up, deep breath in. And then very slowly reach towards the feet, grabbing hold of either your strap, hands around the feet, or perhaps a block behind, just to take you into that deeper stretch. As long as you're leading from the chest, we send the arms up, keeping that spine nice and long, release the hands back down. So we start to come now up onto our hands and knees. We're then going to take the knees wide and send the glutes back on the exhale, as we come into a wide child's pose. So just being in this position, softening the chest down, resting the forehead on the mat, sinking into those hips. Allowing that breath again to be smooth. And then looking forwards, reaching up as you bring the weight forwards. Bring the knees now in, so you're coming into your supportive plank, gazing forwards. Slowly lower the chest down towards the ground. Inhale, push up to your cobra or sphinx by bringing yourselves down to the forearms. Begin to tuck the toes under and send the hips all the way back. Coming into your downward facing dog, pedaling through the knees. Drawing one heel a little bit closer towards the ground. And then take the feet as wide as the mats and lengthen into your downward facing dog. So really pushing through those hands. trying to keep the ears away from the shoulders. Drop down to the knees. We're going to start to lift the right knee, draw it in towards the chest and take it out to the side and back round. So making little circles with the knee. So we're just working into the hip. We're also going to use the core because we're trying to keep the weight evenly distributed between the hands and also by not twisting too much onto the left side. So doing about 8 circles going around, and then bring that knee down, realign yourself, and then again on the left side. So taking that knee all the way in, out to the side and around, 8 little circles. Again, trying to keep the hips in line, trying to keep the weight even through those hands. And then bring the knee down to the mat. Coming just into your cat and cow. And then begin to tuck the toes under, lengthen up into your downward facing dog, pressing through the hands, sending the hips up towards the sky. Bringing the weight forwards, engaging the core and just dropping the hips down into your cobra or sphinx. Just feeling that stretch through the hips and exhale, push back again. And then coming forwards back into cobra or upward facing dog and breathing out into downward facing dog. Start to just ease into twists either side. Send the hips all the way back, working into your downward facing dog. Start to lift that right leg, draw the knee in, gaze forwards. Step the foot through, drop the back knee. Bring the hands to the thigh, center yourself here. And then lift the arms all the way up. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, twist towards that right leg, taking your left arm forwards, your right arm up to the back. Release the hands all the way back down, send the glutes back, straighten your right leg. Flexing the foot, bringing the weight forwards. Inhale, rise. Exhale, twist towards that right leg. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, release the hands down, flexing the foot. And then shifting that weight forwards, walking the foot out to the side of your mat, easing into your lizard lunge. Just moving from side to side. And then taking the right hand all the way around towards the back. Bend that left knee, just gently pulling the foot towards the glutes. This will stretch out through the thigh. Release the right hand down to the ground and come into your lizard pose. Remembering not to hold any tension anywhere else in the body. Noticing how your hips are feeling as you're stretching and opening them out. And then coming up onto the hands, walk the foot to the center of the mat, gazing forwards, lift that back knee, and then begin to drop the back foot. Leading with your left arm, open out into warrior two. So check the alignment of the feet, arms are straight out. Feeling strong. start to bring your right foot in, lift the arms up. Exhale, hinge forwards from the hips, reaching forwards, pausing for a moment, and then release the hands all the way down to the earth. Coming into your side lean, side lunge, moving across to the left foot. Taking your hands now either side of your right foot and stepping it back. Deep breaths in. We start to lift the left foot. Bring the knee in, step it through. Low lunge, drop the back knee. Hands come to the thigh, gazing forwards. Inhale, lift the arms up, stretching up, deep breath in. Exhale, twisting now towards the left leg. Arms are straight out. Lifting up, again another deep breath in. Exhale, frame the foot, send the glutes back, flexing the foot. Inhale, bring the weight forwards. Place the hands onto the thigh. Lifting the arms up towards the sky. Deep breath in. Exhale, we twist towards the left leg. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, framing now your left foot, pushing the glutes back, gazing forwards. And then bring the weight forwards. Walk your foot out now to the side of your mat, easing back into your lizard lunge. And then we send the left arm all the way around towards the back, bending that right knee, grabbing hold of the right foot. And then releasing the hand all the way back down, release the foot, gently easing into your lizard lunge. Again, just making sure that your left knee is over your ankle. Making sure you're not holding tension anywhere. Start to come up onto the hands. And then walking your left foot into the centre, lifting that back knee. Arriving in Anjaneyasana. And then open out into your warrior two, adjusting the feet as you go. And then coming into your warrior two, I'm just going to switch to the other side, so facing the camera. So that your left knee is bent, arms are straight out. Start to bring the feet into the center, lift the arms up. Exhale, hinge forwards. Reaching forwards first and then plant the hands down. And then start to just move from side to side, gently working into your side lunges, coming over to the right foot and then shifting the weight over to that left foot. Coming into Anjaneyasana, our low lunge, stepping the back foot in. And then heel toe the feet out to the side of the mat. We're then going to come down to Malasana, arriving in goddess pose if you prefer. And then you can use a block if you need to, as you gently push the arms to the inside of the knees. This will help to draw the tailbone under so that you're not rounding through the spine. Place the hands down. Exhale, lift the glutes up. Inhale, stretching. If few breaths here in your Uttanasana. Then we come back down on the exhale into Malasana, hands at the heart center, gently easing the upper arms into the side of the knees, and then take the hands behind you. Come and sit yourself back down, arriving in our Baddha Konasana, butterfly pose. Start moving the knees up and down. And then start to come into our hero pose. Now this is the hero pose, which is quite a big stretch through the knee. So as you can see here, I'm sat without any extra support. We're going to do half hero. Now, as I say, it's a very strong asana that is working through the knee joint, and it's going to be working to the inner thigh. So you're either sitting up tall or lying down with your leg straight out, left leg straight, right leg bent. You can then also come to both legs, depending how you're feeling. Now, if this is all too much for the knees, you can sit on a block or a bolster, place that just underneath the glutes, and you can stay upright here. Alternatively, grab hold of a bolster or a block, perhaps play it using a pillow or a rolled up blanket as well. If you want to come and lie down gently onto that extra support, as I've done here, you might find that a little bit easier as well. So there are lots of different options for you to do, either using one side, bringing one knee in and extending the other, or doing both legs sitting up or both legs sitting down. Certainly a pose that works into the inner thighs. We've been stretching the legs out, so we're just doing something that kind of brings our stretch inwards. However, be mindful of how long you hold this pose for. We will not be holding it for very long. So just very gradually ease your way out of your hero pose. If you're using your left or your right side, make sure you've done both. And just massage through the thighs. And then come and lie yourselves down, hugging the knees in towards the chest. Take your two-piece fingers around your big toes. You have an option of keeping the feet here and just resting in the prep for our happy baby. Or you can take one leg up at a time. What you're trying to do is draw the knees in. Try not to come all the way back onto the spine. Make sure the back is making complete contact with the mat. And those knees are drawing in towards the elbows. A little resistance between your fingers and toes. And as I say, you can do one side at a time. Just be mindful of how long you hold it on one side. So you give it an even stretch. Bringing the feet down, take a rest. And when you're ready, going back into your happy baby. And then very slowly bring the feet to the earth, alternating each knee as we begin to close our practice for today. So thank you very much for joining me. You can stay here or come into our Supta Baddha Konasana, recline butterfly pose. You can place a block under the knee if you need to. Be mindful of how long you hold this pose for. And I'll leave you here for the remainder of the time. Take as long as you need. And I will look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste. Thank you for joining in today. Don't forget to hit subscribe in order to follow the remainder of our Christmas Advent yoga sessions. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste.